Are you ready? It's time for another great infotaining show filled with power-packed business and life information. Welcome to Your Future Is Now with your host, Jim Grant, and co-host, Don McGrath. Want to know how you can become an author or speaker or build your own online business? Maybe it's reaching a level of success in your life that you deserve. Their show is designed to provide information to assist you towards your success and destiny. Each week, Jim and Don will interview a special guest and share exciting lessons. So grab a pen and paper. Take some notes. Thanks for joining the show. Now, here's Jim.
Welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Your Future Is Now is proudly brought to you by the good guys at the 6MinuteWebinar.com. At the 6-Minute Webinar, the training that you receive there to be able to, you know, just make your very own 6-Minute Webinar, the first sentence will actually attract your ideal client and it will repel everyone that you cannot help. For example, if during this 6-Minute Webinar, I will show you 3 ways to lose weight. At the end of that sentence, you've already got the people in line that want to say, hey, tell me more. Or the other folks that you cannot help, not interested in your program, how to lose weight, they're gone. So you don't waste anybody's time. But the 6-Minute Webinar, we got the co-founder here, Mr. Bill Heinrich. Bill is also the honorary host here on E360 TV. And he is the author of The 7 Levels of Truth. And he has a great book on clarity. It's an ebook called Clarity Has No Story. You can pick it up at myfreebook.me. That's online, myfreebook.me. And Mr. Bill, welcome to the show, number one. Number two, tell the folks out there a little bit about a webinar on the 6-Minute Webinar coming up, sir, or boot camp.
I will. Thank you, Jim. But let me back up and clean something up. You're such a busy guy. You said, welcome to E360 TV.
Did I really?
Yeah.
Welcome to Your Future Is Now.
You're doing shows in your sleep now.
Oh, man. I do 6 live shows a week. I apologize for that. Thank you for that correction, Bill.
Well, I was concerned because I couldn't see you.
Oh, okay.
If we were on TV, it was like, okay, no, we're on TogiNet. Anyway, yeah, they still, Jim, they still make pencils with erasers on the top, right?
Yeah.
Clean up mistakes. Hey, yeah, there's so many exciting things happening with the 6-Minute Webinar. We're going to be doing a boot camp January 30th. It's a 3-hour boot camp, and you can go to 6minutewebinar.com and get the information on it. One of the most exciting things is we've been doing proof of concept boot camps with it, and this is another one before our big release. And the results people have been getting have been so amazing. So we decided, because we've ended 2020 finally. Normally the boot camp's $99, and anyone can go this time, Jim, for $20.21 for 2021.
I like that.
That's a 3-hour boot camp where you'll get clarity that'll blow you away. And you'll get to meet Script Pal. We've had major, major, major revisions to Script Pal. So the 6-Minute Webinar is a very simple, powerful, effective way to get your message out. And we have in it something that we've developed called Script Pal. You answer some questions and the webinar gets written for you. So come join us January 30th. We're having a lot of fun.
Absolutely. And that's 6minutewebinar.com. Mm-hmm. And all the details are there, just SIXminuteWebinar.com. And this young lady that we have with us today, her name is Tina Ridge. She's got a tremendous story. She's an anxiety coach and speaker. She was one of the ladies on the original webinar series that we put on during the pandemic. The Messages of Inspiration, Hope, and Support was the original title. And after we went through about 300 speakers, going through about 3 different cycles, we got invited to be on that TV show that I heard and mentioned earlier, E360 TV. We're going to be live today with everyday people at 4 o'clock p.m. Eastern. You can catch us on Facebook at Everyday People on Facebook. And we're very excited about that. But Tina is a tremendous young lady. She helped us there. She was on our Everyday, not the Everyday People, but the Message of Inspiration and Hope show right before Christmas. And her message is so powerful. We were honored when we invited her to be here on the show. And Bill, visiting with her, my goodness gracious, she's going to be a blessing to a lot of people, isn't she?
Oh, absolutely. Welcome, Tina. We're glad that you're here.
Hi. Thank you for having me. Really excited to be here with you guys.
Why don't you, in a the easiest thing would be take 30 seconds and tell people who you are and what you love to do.
So I am Tina Ridge, and I actually, Jim said I was an anxiety coach, but I've kind of shifted in my business. And so I'm a leadership mentor now. Mm. And I really focus on teaching women how to step into their leadership and how to connect with their innermost power. And that is what I love to do.
Well, that would certainly get rid of anxiety when you're headed in that direction, right?
Absolutely. And I suffered from anxiety and depression most of my life. And I've pulled myself out of it with lots of help from mentors and coaches. And now I'm just living a life of abundance and freedom. And I just want to help other people that are ready to step into that same life.
So what are three basic steps someone with anxiety has that they could do to start heading in the direction where you're at now emotionally that would help them?
You know, I think the number one thing is to really start to turn your distractions off. We have distractions all around us, and we get into this place of seeing what other people are doing, and we, you know, we might desire to have success like them. And so we look at them and we think, wow, I want that. I want to be like them. I desire that life. And we get so caught up in doing it how that person did it or watching other successful people and not turning inward. And so that would be the first step, I would say, really start to connect with you and drown out some of those distractions. Like, you know, social media is great. I love social media, but when you are using it as a distraction, it can become negative. Mm. So that would be my first step. And the step number two would probably be setting down, journaling out, you know, what are your biggest fears? What is really, you know, if the worst thing happened, what does that mean? And start journaling that. And then I would say step three would be getting clear on what you really want, not what everybody else around you wants for you. So yeah, that's what I would say.
Wow. After, I mean, we haven't connected much before the show, but I do work similar to yours at a very high level with CEOs and very successful entrepreneurs all around the world. And that information, the advice that you just gave, is so rock solid. It's just so rock solid. Amazing.
And Tina, down your pathway of life, you had a very traumatic experience that, you know, kind of, it was a wake-up call. Would you share that with the audience, please?
Sure. Yeah, it definitely was the wake-up call that I needed. You know, I was driving home from work one day on the interstate, and I was in the middle lane, and this dump truck came over and hit my car, spun me sideways, and continued pushing me forward for what felt like an eternity. And in that moment, gripping that steering wheel, I was screaming at the top of my lungs, thinking, I'm never going to see my kids again, my husband, my family. But that was my wake-up call. It was a near-death experience, and it shook me to my core. Mm. And I had so many emotions after that, that I finally said, okay, I can't do this on my own. I need to get help from someone. Mm-hmm. And that started my transformational journey. I started to trust people. You know, I started to see that there are people out there that can help me see what I can't see in myself.
Mm-hmm.
So that led me to really the journey of overcoming my anxiety. I dealt mm-hmm. with anxiety and depression for years, panic attacks, all of it.
Wow. You know, I can just imagine you're sitting there in that car being pushed sideways. I mean, the thing, I understand, you know, how you, I can just visualize I was in that vehicle with you, but, you know, how in the world that thing didn't start flipping is beyond me. In a dump truck, you know, that's a lot of weight. I mean, I can understand, you know, that you figured this is it. My time is, you know, very, very limited in seconds now. And what I admire about you, though, was that you realized, okay, I've got to deal with some things here, and I'm going to reach out to people. And Bill, that's one of the key things in life, is that when you need help, you know, just reach out, because there's a lot of people out there willing to help you in your hour of need, depending on what your need is.
You know, there's, it's, I'm trying to wrap some words around the magic that's available with the different type of protocols available. Isn't that right, Tina? So many people doing so many different things to help people.
Absolutely.
In yeah, these situations.
Yeah. And the abundance really of it all.
Yeah. There's yeah.
Many.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the beauty of it all is just like yourself. And I've been involved in this, Tina, for 25 years, the whole metaphysical piece. And I want to talk to you about that when we come back from our break. But the beauty of it all is all of these different people doing this work, the work that they do comes from their past experience. So they have an extremely intimate awareness of what you might be struggling with. Mm-hmm. And because of that, they can put in a language that you'll understand to help you get out of it and give you a blueprint to move forward. And this is so true. We're going to talk more about this when we come back from the break.
SpeakersPathway.com is the proud sponsor of Your Future Is Now, a show dedicated and aligned in perfect harmony with the vision and mission of Speakers Pathway. Dr. Sony Jackson's expertise is on the art of marketing while cultivating a long-term customer relationship in your business world. Do you know what to say or how to deliver your message to complete strangers? If so, Sony can help you. Tamara Hunter is a cancer survivor and works with people to focus their message or mission to the audience they want to reach. Do you feel called to create a movement to make the world a better place? If so, Tamara can help you. For additional information from any of our executive training directors, go to speakerspathway.com. That is speakerspathway.com.
May's pace of traveling, have you ever accidentally left behind some personal belongings at a hotel? British hotel chain Travelodge just listed some of the more unusual hitheracks and skitheracks they discovered left in rooms over the past year. They found the keys to a $2.5 million Bugatti sports car, a set of breast implants, a diamond encrusted iPhone, and a Rolex watch valued at $82,000. Harry Potter's original wand from the film set was also discovered in one of the rooms. And they were also bumfuzzled to find a set of four Power Ranger costumes and a box of live crabs. Travelodge also reported that some 76,000 teddy bears were reunited with their owners last year alone. What do you call someone who loves teddy bears? An arctophile.
It's Martin Day.
I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Word.
Welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Your Future Is Now is proudly sponsored by the good guys at the 6MinuteWebinar.com. That's SIXMinuteWebinar.com. We got a boot camp coming up and 3 hours worth of training for $20.21 in honor of the year 2021. And today, our guest is Tina Ridge. She's got a tremendous story, and she reaches out and helps ladies. And Bill, you two guys are going to go on a trip. Am I right? Mental trip, is today.
Yeah, well, we're going to go somewhere. Yeah, I've got some questions here for Tina. Mm-hmm. Tina, when this again happened, that accident happened when?
In July of 2018.
Of 2018, so it was just a little over a couple of years ago.
Yeah,
so,
2.5 years.
Yeah, so since that time, what you have come to realize is the bounty and the resources available to all of us through the universe, right?
Absolutely.
And so what are some of the things that surprised you? Because this is so fresh. Like, this was over 25 years ago for me, Tina. So I've been digging into this for a long time.
Yeah.
So what are some of the things that surprised you that just opened your eyes and just went, oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh. So many. But I would say, you know, one of the first things that comes to mind is the love and the support that is around us, mm-hmm. always. And that, mm-hmm. and not only just in the divine way, because I truly believe, you know, we've got divine entities supporting us always. Mm-hmm. But also in, you know, we all have that divinity in us. And so to see the love, to see the world through the eyes of love is the best thing that I've experienced. And this is coming from somebody that didn't trust hardly anyone before this whole transformation journey that I've been on. So I would say that definitely. And then, you know, we were talking earlier about the support piece and trusting, but what has really been the core for me is learning to love myself and trust myself 100%. And that has allowed me to love and trust others unconditionally.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So earlier when you were speaking, I wrote the word trust down because I want to talk about that. What was it that kept you from trusting people?
It was the lack of the trust that I had for myself.
Yeah, well, you get a gold star. That's the right answer. However, what were you going through at the time? What did it appear like when you were stuck in it, this absence of trust?
You know, I didn't have the awareness that I didn't trust myself, obviously, when I wasn't trusting other people.
What were the things you were saying to yourself then?
Oh gosh, I can't do this. I can't do that. You know, what are people going to say?
It'll never work.
It'll never work.
Wait for the other shoe to fall.
Absolutely.
And then you'd go prove that out, right?
Yep. I would manifest. I would manifest that right in my life.
I mean, we've given you a few hints here, but you're talking to an expert in this area, right? And what's important is that the people out there understand what it was like and what you were saying so that they can recognize that that's where they're at.
Yeah. I mean, you know, the self-doubt and I just remember, mm-hmm. you know, being in this place of why am I even here? Why am I even here? Nothing is working out. I'm not getting what I want. What is the point?
Mm-hmm.
But knowing deep down, I was created for so much more. It was always there. Mm-hmm. I just had to
deal with it. Yeah. Yeah. And you had the accident.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's hard to believe you used to be you.
Yeah, it was like,
It's the antithesis of it.
Shedding the old me. It really mm-hmm. wasn't even me, honestly. Who I used to be wasn't really me.
Right. Hmm. Right. Who it was someone that was put together with stories and beliefs that came from their environment and from the authority figures around them. That's what happens to all of us.
Yep.
You know, when we're born, we step right into a life of survival. This is what we're taught. Survival in the physical. And that's where you were hanging out, right?
Yep.
How do I get through today? Now, you're thriving in the non-physical, right?
You know, you say that, but I feel like, you know, for me, it really is the balance of both. Because
you are right. Yes. You're experiencing in the physical is a manifestation of the love you're sharing, and love is non-physical.
Yes, absolutely.
So that's what you're experiencing in the physical. The same way you were experiencing survival with the old energy.
Yep.
That's all you could attract. Yep. What's important for people to know about this to you? Like if you just get up on the podium and yell it out.
The most important thing that I think, you know, especially if someone is listening that is in the depths of anxiety and depression like I was, and it can be hard for us to see and feel our way out when we're in that. But if you're mm-hmm. listening and you're someone that's struggling with that, you have everything you need within you. You mm-hmm. have the power to be, do, and have whatever you want in this life.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, Tina, a lot of people out there listening probably thinking, wow, how can I get in touch with Tina? Would you be so kind as to give your website and your email address before we start winding down, going to break?
Yeah. So my email is Tina Ridge. That's TinaRidge.net. And my email is Tina@TinaRidge.net.
Okay. So your website is Tina Ridge, TinaRidge.net. And your email is simply Tina, TINA@TinaRidge.net. Again, that's TINARIDGE.net.
That's it.
Good. Now that'll also be in the description of the show. And I tell you, whenever listening to Bill and Tina talk and the information they're sharing, it's just one of those deals where when you hear people like that talk from the heart, you know, deep down inside, like, wow, I need to hear this. And I know there's a lot of people out there that's, you know, feeling like that, because that's the beauty in the abundance of love and what I call nurturing the soul. And I don't know what you call it, Bill, but I'm just an old dumb country boy. That's what I call it, because that's exactly what we all need, isn't it?
Yeah. You know, what I like to say, you know, in studying this, Tina, you know, I'm now what I would describe as a master of clarity. And it really just comes down to everything in the universe is a vibration.
Mm-hmm.
And which is scientifically proven, and the universe is infinite, and Earth is not even a speck in the universe, not even a speck. It doesn't even show up when you look at the universe as a whole, but we sit here and think we're the center of the world. And when you start, you know, yeah, it's, you know, my saying, Jim, is I'm not much, but I'm all I think about.
I like that. That's so true.
And when you get caught, there's, as you look at it, Tina, the physical and the non-physical, okay? The physical is all about Earth and what's happening in the physical, and the non-physical is about love and sharing, right?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah.
And what happens when you follow that path?
Everything opens up. I mean, yeah. you look at everything with like the water that I'm drinking right now. It's like, wow, that water is amazing. It nourishes my body. It feels so good. You know, you embrace every little thing. It's beautiful.
Yeah, the magic of it all. You know, it's you see miracles happening everywhere because a miracle is just an unexpected event with a positive outcome. That's all a miracle is. And when you feed into it, they appear. What are some miracles that you've seen? Well, you must see quite a few of them with the women you work with, I would imagine. Is that correct?
Yeah, I've had lots of experiences with my clients where they have, you know, been on antidepressant medications and they have made the decision to come off of them. It gives me chills even to say that out loud.
Let's also say that you're only speaking about something you've witnessed. You're not a doctor.
Correct. And I always recommend.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you. And I always tell them, you know, you go through your doctor and because you want to wean off of them how you need to. And that's definitely, thank you for saying that. Because that is the case. Just seeing things like that and people that have, you know, a lot of women that I work with have stomach issues. And once we process a lot of their emotions, a lot of their limiting beliefs, get that gunk out of their body, start shifting their mindset, their stomach problems go away. And these are like undefined problems. They've had MRIs and CTs and they couldn't figure it out.
Yeah. And, you know, it's amazing how powerful we are. And I know we're going to head to break in just a couple seconds. I want to talk about that and some of the experiences and things that you've seen that have happened with the women that you coach and mentor and work with. We'll be right back. Stay tuned.
This show, Your Future Is Now, is sponsored by SpeakersPathway.com. And just like the show, we are dedicated and aligned in perfect harmony with the same vision and mission of helping people to find their future. Is fear holding you back from your calling or your life mission? Do you struggle with taking that first step? If so, Bill Henrich is our catalyst to help you create perspectives with new possibilities that will bring you more peace, more joy, more love in your life and freedom. Do you struggle trying to build your strategy? Do you know how to reach your end results? If not, Gigi Ames is your expert in strategy and helping you create your step-by-step game plan to reach your finish line. For more information on creating the life you want to live, reach out to Bill Henrich. Or if Gigi Ames can help you with building your strategy with your end goal in sight, go to speakerspathway.com. That is speakerspathway.com.
It's words you never heard.
Man cannot live by bread alone. He must have his peanut butter. Peanut butter is a pate of childhood, and it's not just for kids, as dogs love it too. Last night I gave my dog a pill hidden in peanut butter. What's a word for a messy concoction that helps the medicine go down? Slibber sauce. Mice apparently prefer peanut butter to cheese when it comes to luring them into the trap. But there are even more practical uses for peanut butter. Peanut butter contains natural oils, which makes it perfect for removing all kinds of sticky things, like gum stuck in your shoe or in your hair. What's a word for the fear of peanut butter sticking to the roof of your mouth? Arachnophobia. And according to Barry Goldwater, if you don't mind smelling like peanut butter for 2 or 3 days, peanut butter is a darn good shaving cream.
It's words you never heard.
I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Word.
And welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Your Future Is Now is proudly sponsored by the good guys at the 6MinuteWebinar.com. Our guest today is Tina Ridge. Her website is tinaridge.net. That's T-I-N-A Ridge, R-I-D-G-E.net. And her email is tina@tinaridge.net. And she's a young lady that's sharing a lot of information. And, you know, her and Mr. Bill are having a wonderful conversation because they are both subject matter experts in the world of metaphysics. And Mr. Bill, I tell you right now, I'm really enjoying what I'm hearing. I know the audience out there is too, because you guys are really sharing some golden nuggets out there for everyone.
Yeah, you know, it's really a lot of fun because Tina is so new to this. Mm-hmm. In 2.5 years. I changed, transformed, walked away from my life over 25 years ago. Mm. And who led me to the same place Tina's at. And that's the path. The path of truth takes you to love. And mm-hmm. once you understand love in that manner, it changes your whole life, doesn't it, Tina?
Absolutely. I mean, your eyes are wide open in the best way.
Yeah. Yeah. So when we went on break, we were talking about some of the people that you've worked with who had anxiety and such. What are some of the other symptoms and things that you see so that people can identify with you from the standpoint of how they feel as they're listening to the show and not feeling so well? What are some things that you might say?
Yeah. And again, as you mentioned before, I'm not a doctor. So, you know, if you're experiencing these things, definitely consult your doctor if you are, because one of the things that I hear quite often from my clients is like tightness on the chest or their heart is racing. You know, they have the stomach issues, like I'd mentioned before. But all of these things can manifest from your anxiety. And, you know, it could be other things too. So I want to make that clear. But those have been some things that I have seen. And really, you know, focusing on panic attacks, because that's a big thing that many people, and I myself, used to struggle with. And that's basically the overwhelming feeling that you can't breathe. You can't catch your breath. You literally think you're dying. I thought I was dying the first time I ever had one. They called the ambulance, you know, and I had to breathe into a bag and they had to check my oxygen levels and all of that, my heart rate. And it's very scary, very scary.
Wow, it's amazing. You know, what were some of the stories that you used to be attached to, Tina, that was creating your anxiety?
Well, I experienced a lot of trauma in my life. I was... Mm-hmm. I had been sexually assaulted and stalked by an ex-boyfriend. And so, you know, and other things, death of family members and breakups of relationships and breakups of friendships, you know, all these things. We all have these stories, these traumatic, mm-hmm. painful things that happen in our life. And from all of these experiences, the things that went through my mind was that, you know, what's wrong with you? Why do you keep attracting these people in your life? You're a good person, you know, but you must be broken. I felt broken. Mm-hmm. And felt that I was never good enough to have what I really wanted.
Wow. Yeah, that was not being good enough. That explains the way I spent most of my life until I got so miserable I couldn't take it anymore. Mm-hmm. And that feeling of doing things to try and fit in, to get accepted, and to getting my love outside of me.
You know,
sound familiar?
As you said that, this was exactly what I was getting ready to say, was that I was trying to fill these holes inside of me with other people and other things.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when you've got something going on, in fact, one of the things that I used, Dina, to get that was humor, right? Mm-hmm. I am really funny, okay? But I don't tell jokes anymore. I don't do that because I used to hide behind it. Mm-hmm. And I used to do that to get people's approval. So I stopped.
Wow.
I literally stopped. I still hold my tongue, you know. I'm very quick-witted. But that's how I protected myself, because I felt so lousy on the inside. And if I could have you laughing while you were around me, then that meant you want to be around me. And that made me feel like you loved me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, and I think for me, it was the quietness. I would fall into a quietness. I wouldn't talk. I wouldn't speak. I wouldn't let my voice be heard. I would shrink into that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know,
go ahead, Jim.
I was just going to say, I can relate to that, because in the 70s, I did a lot of joking, tell a lot of jokes and all that, make people laugh, because to me, in my frame of mind, I didn't want anyone to try to get close to me. And I was suffering from a lot of mental baggage from being from Vietnam. And even to this day, I don't wear any veteran camps or Vietnam camps or vests, because I don't have to. You know, I'm comfortable with myself. It doesn't hurt anymore. But I mean, I went through that in the 70s. When you said that, Bill, you just really rang my doorbell, and I had to answer, brother.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, here's what I've found to be true. You know, when you look at everything energetically, and the minute you recognize that, whatever way you're led to, it doesn't matter, does it, Tina? Because you can feel the difference, can't you?
Absolutely.
And it's once you really understand love and touch it, love is being of service for the benefit of all involved. That's all love is. Love isn't the romance, you know. I thought love was the physical romance part growing up, right? And nothing's further from the truth. But we all have so many stories inside us and get caught in that survival, right, Dina? So what's it like? What's it like now that you're thriving?
I feel free. Yeah. I mean, I literally feel free, and people, you know, I think everyone deep down desires, whether they know it or not, to be free, to feel free, but they don't know how to get there. They don't really know what is it? What does it mean? You know, and now I can say, this is what it is. Like, I have it. I live in the moment. I, you know, like you said, the love is all around me. It's in me. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. And even more importantly, you know, when you don't have it.
Absolutely. And, you know, what's amazing about the tools that I use with my clients is that when you fall out of it, you know, I have that awareness now when I fall out of it, and I can process it very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. To get me back into this place.
Yeah. I was just on the phone with a client who's an extremely successful financial consultant. I'll just leave it at that. Very successful, though, over on the East Coast. And he was bringing up being with a group of men where they were doing a mastermind, and he had extensive betrayal. He felt like he was betrayed as a kid, and he looked at everything from a betrayal standpoint. And he was just talking about how incredible it is not to be free of it, because anything that ever enters the system stays there, but to be aware of it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So you have that awareness. What are the things that you recognize when you might be going astray, Tina?
I always pay attention to everything, like the smallest things. If I stub my toe, if I, you know, get
a wake up call.
Get angry at my son, you know, if he knocked a cup over and spilled some water or something. If that
it doesn't take a dump truck anymore.
No. But, you know, it's that the trigger. So if I get triggered by something, I know I need to go into it. There's something there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when you look at the universe and you look at energetics, or everything's a vibration, they talk about the law of attraction, which the law of attraction is just the law of cause and effect. But there are seven basic laws that run the universe, and you've got to use all of those. But cause and effect is in effect every moment, because another one of the laws is duality, where you have to have duality in the universe. This is the way it keeps itself, the yin yang, how it keeps itself balanced.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And when you start recognizing that, you can make sure that, well, I like to say, I'm making the bed today that I'll sleep in tomorrow.
Oh, I love that.
That's a neat way of saying it. 'Cause you know, Bill, you know, myself, and I mean, I've steered away from watching other stuff that's real negative, that everybody has an abundance around them, because all it does is drag me down. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you can't look at stuff like that or listen to stuff like that if it's polluting. You know, your spirit is like a beautiful, clear spring. And if you want to, you know, you're thirsty, you're not going to put mud in your spring or anything like that before you drink out of it. And why would you, you know, put mud in your mind and then try to live an abundant life? I mean, that just doesn't work, folks. It didn't go together any more than snow at harvest time, for goodness sakes.
Well, we're actually fortunate enough, believe it or not, to see that being played out now on the international political scene. Mm-hmm. And its cause and effect is in play.
Yeah.
And it's going to be really interesting. Whoa, we're headed to commercial. We'll be back in just one moment.
Your Future Is Now is sponsored by SpeakersPathway.com, and just like the show, we are dedicated and aligned in perfect harmony with the same vision and mission of helping people define their future. You may have heard that a picture is worth 1,000 words. Well, a video is worth 1,000 pictures. Koji Simaldi says, if you're not using video in 2019, you're going to get left behind. Most people feel lost or confused when it comes to marketing. Preston Martelli is a marketing guru whose strategies are both art and science in growing your business. Preston helps you make the right decisions that are predictable, measurable, and scalable. For additional information about Koji, Preston, or any of our executive training directors, go to our website at speakerspathway.com. That is speakerspathway.com.
Know that the breakup of a close friend's marriage can increase the chances of your own marriage breaking up by 75%. Apparently, divorce is contagious. A study on marriage and divorce spanning 32 years has now been titled, Breaking Up is Hard to Do Unless Everyone Else is Doing It Too. The Harvard University study found that divorce is like a virus, weakening the marriages closest to it. What's a word for an unhappy marriage? Phagomosis. If your sibling is divorced, you're 22% more likely to get divorced. And if most of your coworkers are divorced, you're 55% more likely to end your own marriage. Personally, I'm more of a coothery-oothery kind of person. That's someone who enjoys the closeness of marriage. In fact, if it weren't for marriage, my husband would go through life thinking he had no faults at all.
It's Marching Neighbor.
I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Word.
Well, Welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Your Future Is Now is proudly sponsored by the good guys at the 6MinuteWebinar.com. We got a webinar coming up, our boot camp, 3-hour boot camp for $20.21. Can you believe that? That's in honor of 2021, so we can say goodbye to 2020. We can welcome 2021. Just go to 6SIXMinuteWebinar.com. Take a look at it. And I promise you, I give you my word, ladies and gentlemen, you'll be glad that you did. And I'm joined today by the co-founder of the 6-Minute Webinar. He's also the honorary host here on TogiNet, Mr. Bill Heinrich. And our guest is a great friend of ours, Tina Ridge. And when you hear, she's just been giving us all kind of great information. Her and Bill has just been, you know, throwing nuggets, golden nuggets out there left and right. And I'm sitting here and I'm thinking, man, you know, we could take this show on the road. You know that, Bill?
Well, Jim, I've got some good news for you.
What's that, brother?
Well, because I live in an RV, the show is on the road.
Okay. Hey, we're off to a great start then.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. We need a circus tent. That's what we need. Yeah, this has been fun. So before we get into it again, Tina, please, you know, let me just say this. I've been doing this work for a long time. And this, Tina is quite a woman. She, if you need help in this area, I just can't recommend her enough. You'll notice that when she talks, she doesn't say much. The reason she doesn't is when you get connected to what's true, truth doesn't carry a lot of words, does it, Tina? But before you answer that question, tell people how to get a hold of you.
Okay, you can visit my website at tinaridge.net, or you can email me at tina@tinaridge.net. I'm also on all the social medias, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram. So yeah, check me out.
Great, thanks, Tina.
Absolutely. And I'd like to add, if I may, real quickly, if you go to YouTube, Messages of Inspiration and Hope, and all the she was on the TV show, you can see Tina in action, and she was interviewed there. So it's right before Christmas. So, you know, just check her out, because this lady is just extra special.
Oh, thank you.
So I'd like you to say something about the simplicity with which you speak, Tina, because you see, when we look at things from a vibration, everything in the universe being a vibration, a lot of people are always telling stories that they were buying into or they wanted somebody else to buy into. But as you move through the connection with yourself and love, things get simple, don't they?
So simple. You know, it's so amazing to be able to just connect with my soul, with my intuition. And, mm-hmm. you know, I talk a lot about taking inspired actions, and it kind of goes back to what you're saying, like the simplistic of it, because when you really connect in with your intuition and knowing the knowing of what you should do next, what action you should take, what mm-hmm. you should say, what you should speak, it just comes so easily, and it's that freeing. You know, I keep going back to that word, freedom, but it really is.
Yeah, I've had to kind of chuckle this year because of, in a sense, with the pandemic, not because of the pandemic, but the new buzzword in business is pivoting. But I didn't pivot. I used another P word, and it's called pause. To be still. Stillness in the chaos. And what happens what happens when you're in fear is you have to be in action in some way, shape, or form.
And another P word comes to mind, which is panic. We saw a lot of that, didn't we?
And another one, Jim, which is called protect.
Yes.
Panic and protect, right? Mm-hmm. Right. Do you connect with that, Tina?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it is so important to be still, be with yourself, You know, I talked about this in the beginning, where we look so much outside of ourselves and get so distracted by things. And then we take action because we feel like we need to. Mm-hmm. But do you really want that? Does it really feel good for you?
Right. Yeah. The need of survival.
Mm-hmm.
Something to help you survive. Whether it's doing something so you can avoid how you actually feel.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Or doing something because you've got to have more.
Yeah. And doing those things that distract us, like you were saying, to keep you from feeling, you know, I focus a lot on emotions with my clients and helping mm-hmm. them to learn how to process them in a healthy way and not judge themselves around their emotions. And when we can get to that place of our emotions are just our emotions and it's okay. They're there for, they're actually a gift to help us process whatever's coming up.
You know, not only are they a gift, Tina, our emotions, as you call them, or let me say it a different way, how we feel is the only thing on earth that's true. Mm. Everything else is a perception.
Mm. mm-hmm.
You feel sad, you're sad, which is okay.
Mm-hmm.
So when you source, I mean, again, I've been doing this a long time. You cannot have an emotion without a story.
Yep.
Mm, that's true.
You have to have a story. So when you feel that way, go look at the stories mm-hmm. that don't serve you anymore. They served you when you were in survival. Don't be angry with them. Love them. They, yes. They've got you to this point. Right, Tina? Oh,
you are speaking my language.
Oh, I told you. I can keep going, Tina. We could go on quite a ride. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Say something about that, Tina. It's about that survival and the stories.
You know, we are trying to protect ourselves. The P word that you said earlier.
Yeah. Yeah.
Protect. And we are in our society, we are basically taught, don't feel, don't, you have to be strong. You can't, don't cry about that. Don't be angry. God wouldn't want you to be angry. Like all these things
right.
that are out
right.
there, you know, and it just feeds that. It feeds that, oh my gosh, I can't be upset. I can't be sad. I can't be angry. What's wrong with me? And it feeds the stories.
Mm-hmm.
Instead mm-hmm. of allowing yourself to feel it, experience it, and be.
Yeah, you know, the problem is a lot of people know this, but one of the things that I've experienced, I'm still experiencing because I'm in a constant state of change. I'm always, okay, I want to like mm-hmm. keep growing because mm-hmm. life is about clarity. It's about learning lessons and it's exciting and it's fun. But one of the things that I had difficulty with for quite a while was coming to grips with saying goodbye to my old self. Like, I had a very intimate relationship with that person, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it was really interesting how I was afraid what it would be like if I didn't have him with me anymore. It took me quite a while to see that was something that was still blocking me years into my studying of this. Like I've taken this to extremely intricate levels, but because we were protected in that life of survival, we were protecting ourselves. There were things that you had to do that don't serve you anymore. Right, Dana?
Yeah. And you know, what resonated with me when you were saying that is, for me, what gave me the most clarity was learning that I really hated myself. Mm-hmm. I hated who I was, which wasn't really who I am, if that makes sense. It's kind of confusing, maybe.
Totally.
But I hated the person that I had become because it wasn't me. And I had to learn how to love me.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. You know, one of the things I wrote a, well, I've written a number of books, but one of the, I guess it was more of a, not an article, I don't know what you'd call it, but it's called The Seven Saboteurs, The Things That Sabotage Our Life. And the one at the top of the list, the worst one of all, is defensiveness. Because love doesn't need defense, does it, Tina?
No, no. And you, you think about, like, I was just thinking about the, you know, past relationships and things where I would get so defensive on certain things. And it is so true. So true.
Yeah. Yeah. Fear creates the need to defend and protect. And these are the little things that I look for, because these are things that people understand.
Yeah.
So if you're always coming from a defensive place, what is it that you need to, what story do you need to protect? What story feels like it needs protection because it's keeping you in a state of rigidity? Unless you rewrite the story, or when you see that come up, you make a choice that's just the opposite, right, Tina? Go the opposite direction.
Exactly. And another thing too is like comparison and competition.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, let me give you a word for that. Measurement.
Yeah.
Any measurement.
Yeah, that's yeah.
Well, Jim, this is been a kind of slow moving show. We didn't have much to talk about, did we?
Ah, I tell you. you know, ladies and gentlemen, I went back and while they were visiting there, I checked the website there, the Tina's website. And I just want to very quickly say her website and email address will be in the description of the show. But she talks about learn a step-by-step process to remove negative energy from your body. And also on YouTube, it's season one, episode 13. I will download that show and have that link there for you to make it easy so you can get a chance to meet Tina and Tina at tinaridge.net. We want to thank you so much, Tina, for being with us today. And my goodness gracious, thank you for making this show, you and Bill both, for making this show a hit. I'm Jim Grant. We'll see you next week.
Thank you.